You are listening to New Nation Radio, WNOD.
New Nation Radio, we dance radio.
Bam! Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the show. This is the Black Empowerment Movement. Man, it's our third season, and we back on it. And we back to a good start. Sorry, yeah, I'm late, but you know how black people do, man. How everybody doing? Welcome to the show once again. And tonight, man, we talking about Sandra Bland. We talking about the 1 year anniversary of Michael Brown. And we're also talking about the college kid that just got shot at a car dealership tonight. Tonight's topic, we're also talking about what is the safe way to survive a traffic stop in America. All right? So we're going to go ahead and get to this music, and when we come back, y'all know how we do, man. We're gonna drop some knowledge, and we're gonna share with each other. Hope y'all been doing good. Yeah, shout out to everybody listening. This is BIM New Nation Radio. It's your boy Science Man. All right, all right.
Harassing. Imagine going to court with no trial. Lifestyle cruising blue behind my waters. No welfare supporters. More conscious of the way we raise our daughters. Days are shorter, nights are colder. Feeling like life is over. These snakes strike like a cobra. The world's hot, my son got knocked. Evidently, it's elementary. They want us all gone eventually. Trooping out of state for a plate. Knowledge, if coke was cooked without the garbage, we'd all have the top dollars. Imagine everybody flashing, fashion, designer clothes. Lacing your click up with diamond rolls. Your people's holding dough. No parole, no rubbers. Going raw, imagine law with no undercovers. Just some thoughts for the mind. I take a glimpse into time. Watch the blend read, the world is mine.
If I rule the world,
imagine that.
I free all my sons. I love them, baby. Black diamonds and pearls.
Could it be, if you could be mine, we both shine.
If I rule the world,
still living for today. In these last days of time, the way to be. Paradise life relaxing, black, Latino, and Anglo-Saxon. Armani exchange the range, cast, lost tribe of Shabazz, free at last, brand new whips to crash. Then we laugh in the iller path, the villa houses for the crew, how we do, trees for breakfast, dime sexes have been stretches. So many years of depression make me vision, the better living, type of place to raise kids in. Opening eyes to the lies, history's told foul, but I'm as wise as the old owl, plus the gold child, seeing things like I was controlling, click rolling, tricking six digits on kicks and still holding trips to Paris. I civilize every savage. Give me one shot, I turn tripe life to lavish. Political prisoner set free, stress free. No work release, purple M3s and jet skis. Feel the wind breeze in West Indies. I lick Coretta Scott King, mayor of the cities, and reverse things to Willie's. It sound foul, but every girl I meet to go downtown. I'd open every cell in Attica, send them to Africa.
If I rule the world,
imagine that. Thugs living worried, duck down in car seats, heat's mandatory. Running from Jake, getting chased, hunger for papes. These are the breaks, many mistakes, go down out of state. Wait, I had to let it marinate, we carry weight, trying to get laced. Flip the A stack to safe, millionaire plan to keep the gap with the cock camera. Making moves in Atlanta, back and forth scrambler. Cause you can have all the chips, be poor or rich, still nobody want a nigga have a shit. If I ruled the world and everything in it, sky's the limit. I push the Q45 infinite, it wouldn't be no such thing as jealousies or be felony. Strictly living longevity to the destiny I thought I'd never see, but reality struck. Better find out before your time's out. What the fuck?
If I rule the world,
imagine that.
I free all my sons. I love
days and times.
If I ruled the world,
imagine that.
I'd free all my sons.
I love my home, baby.
Black diamonds and pearls.
Black diamonds,
could
black
it be?
Diamonds.
If you could be mine, we both shine.
If I ruled the world,
still living for today in these last days and times.
If I ruled the world. That's
just the way it is. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. That's just the way it is.
What up, everybody? It's your girl Coco, host of the new show, Sister Girl on the Nation Radio, Mondays at 9 a.m.
Welcome back to the show. This is Bim, and if you are tuned in, if you are listening, you are now part of the revolution, man. We are the movement, and we are the people who the American government and Congress are scared of. We are the ones that are awakened to what's really going on around us. We are the people and the ones that need to actually put in step and put in action things that will change the future for our kids, man. Check this out. So welcome back to the show. Welcome back to the revolution. And welcome back. We are broadcasting live from Galveston County. This is Black Empowerment. So let's talk about Sandra Bland, man. A regular traffic stop. I seen a video, she thought that she was getting out the officer way, so she pulled over without signaling. But the police, you know, he took it as she ain't signaling when she got over, so he mowed her over. He pulled her over. Alright, regular traffic stop. And things has got out of control. Now, how to survive a traffic stop while living in America? First of all, you can survive if you ain't black. I hate to say that, but if you ain't black, you already got a high percentage and a chance of making it out of the situation alive. So you ain't got to worry about that. But the main thing you got to worry about is you got to stay in control, and you can't disrespect these officers. See, these officers, they real soft-hearted, or they sensitive, or somewhere in their training, it don't train them to take verbal abuse. You know what I'm saying? When you talk to police officers, it's like you can't even say nothing to them. When you get out of line or when you voice your opinion, they attack you. So the first way to survive a traffic stop is control your temper, right? You gotta understand that officer has the right and the law behind him to kill you if he think that you're getting out of line or you are irate, alright? So don't be a dummy and try to get an attitude with the law. See, and that's what Miss Sandra Bland did. God rest her soul. Yet and still, that don't give an officer a reason to attack a woman, to provoke a woman, no matter if she committed suicide, or no matter if it was foul play. And we'll talk about that later. Also later, I got some exclusive audio of the traffic stop that happened between Sandra Bland and the officer. The altercation happened in Prairie View, Texas. And I think I've been through Prairie View, Texas a couple of times. And them officers, man, they do look kind of like they'll pull you over and look at you strange, man. And it's like that. And if you ever been to Vida, Texas, if y'all ever, any listeners, if y'all in Texas, man, y'all know in Vida, Texas, black people just won't go to Vida, Texas. And it's just something I never do. I make sure I'm gassed up before I even pass through there, because they still believe in lynching and killing black people. So that's what it is. But so that was one way to survive being, one way to survive a traffic stop in America, all right? So when we come back, we'll get back to Sandra Bland. We'll talk about a little bit of Michael Brown and get some empowerment going on, all right? This is BIM, New Nation Radio. It's your boy.
You know, don't nothing come easy. You got to try real, real hard. I try hard. But I guess I got to try hard.
I try so hard. Seem to get away from misery. Man, I try so hard. Always be a victim of
up right here and sleep your soul up. Until then, I'll be posting up right here with my heat.
First let me explain that I'm just a black man, black and I come from the dark side, so I'm having a hard time staying on track, man. My mind be racing, and I don't even know what I'm chasing yet. Been in and out of relationships, I'm starting to see that it's me with the complications at. But I'm laying back, praying that you get that peace of mind of me. I thought I was right, but really I'm wrong, and again I was too blind to see. I was in the fast lane, chasing my dream, and then the scene when the fame and cash came, they just got me going crazy. I've been so faded, trying to erase it, but I just can't, cause the drama just goes greater. And I've been in so many collisions, crumpling relations up to later.
I try so hard, can't seem to get away from misery. Man, I try so hard, always be a victim of history. It ain't my fault, cause I try to get away, but trouble follows me. And still I try so hard, hoping one day you'll come and rescue. Posted up right here, ain't sleep, hell, so what? Until then, I'll be posted up right here with my feet getting dough.
It's like I'm taking 5 steps forward and 10 steps back, trying to get ahead of the game, but I can't seem to get it on track. And I keep running away to ones that say they love me the most. How could I create the distance when it's supposed to be close enough? I just don't know, but I'll be out here fighting demons, and it's like a curse that I can't shake this part of Cleveland. And Lord, would you help me and stop this pain I keep inflicting on my family? Hustling and gambling, tricking and scambling, and losing sight of what I'm supposed to be handling. It's hard to manage, cause every day's a challenge. And man, I'm slipping, can't lose my balance, I'm trying not to panic.
I try so hard, can't seem to get away from misery. Man, I try so hard, always be a victim of history. It ain't my fault, cause I try to get away, but trouble follows me. And still I try so hard, hoping one day you'll come and rescue me. But until then, I'll be posted up right here and sleep hell snow up. Until then, I'll be posted up right here with my feet getting low, getting low.
I see things won't change, I'm stuck in the game. As soon as I get out, it keeps pulling me back, got me doing dirty, dirt. So used to this hustle money that I don't understand, I'm not a fire word. Studied on the streets, hustlers know what I mean. Hustlers balling before us, I'm trying to make that major league. So it never leaves. Till the sun came up, gotta get it, no leaving, no rush. Today game they play, gotta go hard and get what you put in. If you fall off, then it's all on you. Gotta watch what you sign to. Try so hard, but I won't
let I try so hard, can't seem to get away from misery. Man, I try so hard.
Sit up right here and sleep hell snow. But until then, I'll be posted up right here with my heat getting low, getting low.
She's just a girl and she's on fire, hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire, filled with catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away. Oh, she got both feet on the ground and she's burning it down. Oh, she got her head in the clouds and she's not backing down.
This girl is on fire.
She on fire, she on fire. This is Bim. What's up, everybody? Wake up. This is the revolution. And America is out to get us. The European is out to get us. They know that we are learning the truth. What is the truth? Well, first of all, if you've never been to the show, welcome to the show, man. The truth is, they know that we know that we are the first people on earth. The skin, our melanin, is found in the universe. They have none. We are the children of God. You understand me? So they know that we know this. And that's why they want to get rid of us. That's why they never want us reading books. And that's why now in present day they are sacrificing us and killing us the same way they've been doing since the beginning. Now, Sandra Bland, I understand, man. She got out of line and she got a little irate with the police officer. And, you know, I know a little law, so I know that it's against the law. Well, she ain't have to put out the cigarette. You understand me? But as soon as the police tell you to get out the car, you got to get out the car. And that's, you know, his power within the law. So he tell you to get out the car, you get out the car. And, you know, you basically, yes, sir, no, sir, yes, ma'am, no, ma'am. Anything outside of that is, to them, offensive. So now they see you as offender, you know, somebody who breaking the law. Excuse me. Somebody who breaking the law. So I'm gonna play some of this exclusive footage from this when they pulled over Miss Sandra Bland. Rest in paradise, man, for real. May God's angel avenge you. I'm sorry, y'all. Just real pissed off about it. I don't understand why they killing women, why they killing our men, why they killing, you know what I'm saying, why we got our soldiers over there fighting in the country when we need them at home fighting for us. You understand? So it's crazy. But so that's what happened, man. So let's get to this video. This happened in Prairie View, Texas. And I didn't know it was that crazy down there. Okay, I'm trying to find it real fast. Give me a second. But you got to know that in America, man, what the Ku Klux Klan and everything did. Listen.
So I move over and you stop me. So yeah, I am a little irritated, but yeah, that doesn't stop you from giving me a ticket.
Right. So. Are you done?
You asked me what's wrong and I told you.
Okay.
So now I'm done, yeah.
Okay. You mind putting out your cigarette, please? Don't mind.
I'm in my car. Why do I have to put out my cigarette?
Well, you can step on out now.
I don't have to step out of my car.
Step out of the car.
No, you don't have the right. You do not have the right to do that.
I do have the right. Now step out or I will remove you.
I refuse to talk to you other than to identify myself.
Step out or I will remove you.
I am getting removed for a failure.
Step out or I will remove you. I'm giving you a lawful order. Get out of the car now or I'm going to remove you.
And I'm calling my
police. I'm going to yank you out of here.
Okay, you're going to yank me out of my car?
Get out.
Okay. All right.
25.
Yeah,
don't touch me.
Get out of the car. Don't touch me. I'm not under arrest. You don't have the right to say
you are under arrest.
I'm under arrest for what?
25-27 County Airfield 1098.
For what?
290 Simulator Unit. Get out of the car. Get out of the car now.
Why am I being apprehended? You're trying to give me a ticket.
I said get out of the car.
Why am I being apprehended?
You I'm going to get off the car. I'm going to drag you out of here.
So you're going to drag me out of my own car?
Get out of the car.
And then you
I will light you up. Get out.
Wow.
Now.
Wow.
Get out of the car.
Right, for a failure to signal. You're doing all of this for
get
a
get over there.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, let's take this to court. Let's
go ahead.
For a failure to signal. Yeah, for a failure to signal.
Get off the phone.
Let's go.
Get off the phone.
I'm not on the phone. I have a right
put
to report.
Put your phone down.
Property.
Put your phone
property.
Down.
Sir?
Put your phone down. Right now. Put your phone down. Come over here.
Y'all are interested.
Come over here now.
You feeling good about yourself?
Stand right here.
You feeling good about yourself?
Stand right here.
You feel your signal. You feel real good about yourself, don't you?
Turn around.
You feel good about yourself, don't you?
Turn around now.
What are you?
Put your hands right back and turn around. Turn around.
Why can't you tell me
I'm giving you a lawful order. I will tell you.
Why am I being arrested?
When I come back, y'all, I got more of that disturbing, unlawful traffic stop, man. And that was, she had to get out the car. You know, that's if a police officer feel like, you know what I'm saying, they need you to get out the car, you gotta get out the car. You can't go against that. She ain't have to put a cigarette out, and he ain't have to drag her. But I got a call. Hold on real fast. Hey, what's up, Lou? Welcome to the show, man. Uh-oh. Scared the nigga. And when I say nigga, I mean N-E-G-U, which I found out means Ethiopian king or ruler. Some people try to disclaim it, but like I said, on this show, man, you got to go and you got to look up everything yourself. All I can do is try to tell you what I know, and I really want to know everything that y'all know so we can power each other. We dropping in on somebody. Hey, what's up, Master Lou?
Hello?
Hey, man, welcome to the show, man. Bim, what's up with you?
Hey, chillin', what's going on with you?
Nothing, man. We talking about Sandra Bland, and we talking about how do you survive a traffic stop in America?
Without getting shot in your ass, huh?
Without getting killed, without getting electrocuted. How would you survive a traffic stop, Master Lou?
Let's see, honestly, and as much as I hate to say this, you just have to, well, not hate to say it, because it's just common sense. You really do have to be respectable. Even if you get pulled over for the most innocent reason, cops tell you your light out, or you didn't signal, or you didn't put your signal on fast enough before you turn. No matter how fucking ridiculous it sounds that they're pulling you over, just be respectable. Until they get disrespectful with you, even though you think being pulled over is disrespectful enough, we totally understand. You just have to be respectable. You got a yes sir, no sir, and you ain't even got a really yes sir. You can yeah no if all your paperwork right, but if you already know you in the wrong, don't talk about shit. They gonna get you. Now you don't want to get shot. Yes sir, no sir. My insurance is right here, sir. You go off, man, you get the popping off of these cops. Believe me, I'm a first-hand witness. I didn't get my ass whooped, but I was treated very unjust just for popping off at the mouth, even though I was in the right.
I mean, you gotta watch how you handle
yourself. No more uno way to stay alive, man, is to be as respectable to a cop as you would be to your mom.
Yeah. That's how you live. That's how you'll survive in America, especially with brown skin, man.
Only way to not get shot. You ain't gotta get shot now. Nah, you know, they lock you up and you just coming out dead now. That's the new trend.
Yeah, everybody acting surprised, man. They acting surprised because it's a black woman, but even you know, man, they been attacking our black women since way back, huh?
Oh, yeah, and that's the thing. We think that women have an attitude for no reason. They've been getting disrespected for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Even when being the rock of a family, man, they still got to go out and bear the worst of it. Because, you know, we already know white people don't really give a fuck about their own women. Mm-hmm. Whether you know it or not, the black man had a vote before the white woman did. So, you know, you just look into that. That's the 100% truth. The white woman couldn't vote before a black man could.
Yeah. That tells you a lot. That tells you a lot about how they treat their women and how
they treat a whole lot. And if they don't respect their own women, the rock of everything, the foundation of everything, and guess what? They really care less about your black
man. Exactly, man. That's how really we talking about, man. Just trying to make sure we empower everybody to really be safe out there when you dealing with the police, man. Because I feel like, man, they be looking forward to killing black people. Like, they, you know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, initiation or like some kind of rites of passage, you know what I'm saying? Like,
think about it. If you see a bunch of other white cops, just say you're a white cop. You see a bunch of other white cops getting rewarded for killing niggas.
Yeah.
Rewarded meaning they getting off of their charges, they getting $100 million GoFundMe pages. Just look at Zimmerman. Nigga, you get paid to kill niggas. That dude wasn't rich when he whacked Trayvon Martin. Oh, he's rich now.
That nigga had little money because he born it out of jail, but I don't know if that was his sympathizers or whatever, but I thought he had
no money. He didn't have that money. You know who put up his bond?
Who that?
Johnson & Johnson. The people who make all the white paper towels and the white paper plates and the white spoons and the white forks, they went and saved that white ass.
Oh, ain't that a bitch?
Yes, the people who put our money into.
Excuse my language.
They the same folks you buy toilet paper from is that same money bailed out straight. Bailed out the nigga that killed Trayvon Martin.
Nah, What about this right here, man? They killed Christopher Taylor, that young college dude, around or on the same day anniversary as Michael Brown. You think that shit was
anniversary?
You think that was a coincidence?
That video is correct. Mind you, now we can't just jump on every bandwagon, like every nigga that gets shot. If the video was true, if there was a pistol that man was holding, I mean, he couldn't expect it, nothing less. Go out to a place full of hatred-filled cops.
You talking about?
Full of energy-filled brothers, and you got a pistol.
You can't even have
not the best move.
You can't even have a water gun, man. Like, and be black.
Hell no, you can't have a cap gun. Even though they sell them at the corner store with our kids.
Yeah.
They ain't for your kids. What you need to remember. I'm toy guns with my little...
Oh, man, nigga, phone hung up. Call him back. But yeah, man, he on to something, man. We all on to something. We here to learn from each other, man. And we soaking up the game, and he dropping jewels.
But the person you called has a voice.
So we gonna do this, man. We tried to call him back. You know how we do. This is Ben Black Empowerment, man. And I just want to make sure that everybody understand that they've been destroying our women since the beginning. See, they've been in the minds of our women since the beginning. Of slavery, of the great deception, great betrayal, whatever you want to call it. And so they have no problem killing a black woman. You understand me? Because they know that they get more points, you know, in their heads for killing a black woman than a black man. The black woman is, you know, she's the one that brings the black family amongst the earth. You know, she, you know what I'm saying? She gave birth to the generation. So they don't have a problem with killing black women, man. And that it really hurt to see. Now, they were saying that she was already suicidal. They were saying that she was a little bipolar. You understand me? But I understand that. But at the same time, the condition, the mental state of someone shouldn't justify murder or, you know, I can't say he murdered her, but you know, it can't justify unlawfulness on the behalf of the law. You know what I'm saying? If they here to protect us, then they should be able to maintain and calm down the situation, no matter who the person is, psychologically, physically, or whatever. Or if that's the case, then they shouldn't have a badge. They shouldn't be responsible for life and death if they can't control their tempers and situations, and if they just out to kill people. See, that's why I think they need psychological evaluations on different levels before you even join the police academy. Because you never know who. You can have a serial killer who just happened to go to police academy and get a badge. Now he living a dream because all he do is watch movies, and now he want to kill black people and, you know, make a name for himself. So you never know what's going on in the world. We're going to talk about much more when we come back. I'm going to call Lou back, and I'm going to drop in on somebody else. Y'all listen to BM, Black Empowerment Movement. And I'm feeling good, y'all. I feel empowered. Y'all be cool.
Most incredible, baby. I can't see him coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry. I can't see him coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry. Good dude, I know you love me like cooked food, even though it's gotta move like a crook move. We was together on the block since free lunch. We should have been together having Four Seasons brunch. We used to use umbrellas to face the bad weather, so now we travel first class to change the forecast. Never in bunches, just me and you. I loved your point of view cause you held no punches. Still I left you for months on end. It's been months since I checked back in. We're somewhere in a small town, somewhere locking them all down.
Damn.
Going change, I'ma roll down. I can understand why you want a divorce now, though I can't let you know it. Pride won't let me show it. Pretend to be heroic, that's just one to grow with. But deep inside it, so sick. I can't see him coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry. I can't see them coming down my eyes, so I gotta let the song cry. I can't see it coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry. I can't see it coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry. On repeat, the CD of Biggs, me and my b- watching Bonnie and Clyde pretending to be that empty in your hand saying, let me see that shopping sprees, pull out your Visa quick. Had very bad credit, you helped me lease that whip. You helped me get the keys to that V.6. We were so happy poor, but when we got rich, that's when the signals got crossed and we got flipped. Rather mine, I don't know what made me leave that, made me speed that quick. Let me see, that's it, it was the cheese, help them get amnesia quick. I used to cut up they buddies, now they saying they love me. Used to tell they friends I was ugly and wouldn't touch me. Then I showed up in that dubbed out buggy, and then it got fuzzy and they don't remember that, and I don't remember you. I can't see it coming down my eyes, so I gotta make this song cry. I can't see it coming down my eyes, so I gotta make this song cry. Yeah, I seen them coming down your eyes, but I gotta make this song cry. I can't see it coming down my eyes, so I gotta make this song cry. A face of stone was shocked on the other end of the phone. Word back home is that you had a special friend. So what was oh so special then? You have given away without getting at me. That's your fault. How many times you've forgiven me? How was I to know that you was plain sick of me? I know the way in living was whack. She don't get it back like that. I'm a man with pride. You don't do like that. You don't just pick up and leave and leave me sick like that. You don't throw away what we had just like that. I was just them girls. I was gonna get right back. They say you can't turn a bad girl good, but once a good girl's gone bad, she's gone forever. I'm on forever. I gotta live with the fact I did you wrong forever. I can't see them coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry. I can't see them coming down my eyes, so I gotta let the song cry. I know I seen them coming down your eyes, but I gotta make the song cry. I can't see them coming down my eyes, so I gotta make the song cry. What's up, girl?
Bam.
Lloyd Banks, you know, cause it thuggin' on me, he don't wanna see you smile, baby.
He wanna be the reason you smile. He wanna be the reason you smile. He wanna be the reason you smile. After you wipe away your tears and dry your eyes.
I'm getting the feeling you wanna take revenge. Conversations we have in the way it ends. You wanna discuss me in front of your lady friends. That's why it's just me and my Mercedes Benz. It all depends, maybe if we make amends, we can start from scratch. Learn to control your temper and remarks in fact. We plan to be platonic with the hearts intact. So every time we separate, somebody's marching back. You're amazing in the sack. Eyes slanted like you're Asian, but you're black. God bless whoever gave you all of that. Seen her from the back, you understand why they stare like that. It ain't a photo with toes, the Lord knows. Still good enough to miss award shows. And I ain't gotta say nothing, she just knows. By the way I look at her, don't take off all the clothes up and down. When I'm not around, and you're feeling down, let the thought of me be
easy and smile.
I don't wanna see you frown like when kids watch a clown. I wanna bring you joy and
be easy and smile.
Be in on my style. You know how I get down, I provide by any means to be
easy and smile.
We done been through ups and downs, had drama for a while. I'm just happy I'm around to be
easy and smile.
The main reason I've been looking at you pitiful. Been out the half of this shit that I done did to you. Violated and tiptoed into a crib or two. I've come clean to be a bigger individual. Even though you're visible to evens when I visit you. Kinda makes me feel lucky cause I see you when you teasing with your physical. She wanna wreck up the rooms, I ain't got no more wind left. Wow, by my Section 8 princess. My foreign chick bad, but she been stressed. Plus it's hard to communicate cause she don't speak in no English. I've been around the world state to state, but now I'm back in your bathroom. Got you laughing in your shower cap, let's get it on. Cause I'm leaving in an hour flat, but it don't matter, she's mad even when I holler back. All I really need your attention for a while, and I bet you I can make you smile whenever I'm not around. And you're feeling down, let the thought of me be your easy smile. I don't wanna see you frown like when kids watch a clown. I wanna bring you joy and be your easy smile. Baby, you know my style, you know how I get down. I provide by any means to be your easy smile. We done been through ups and downs, had drama for a while. I'm just happy I'm around to be your easy smile. Whenever I'm not around and you're feeling down, let the thought of me be your easy smile. I don't wanna see you frown like when kids watch a clown. I wanna bring you joy and be your easy smile. Baby, you know my style, you know how I get down. I provide by any means to be your easy smile. We done been through ups and downs, had drama for a while. I'm just happy I'm around to be your easy smile.
Hi, what's up? It's your girl Jada Stone. You already know to quit calling my phone, but you can check me out on NNOD, New Nation Radio, the hottest station in the country. And if that doesn't work for you, check me out on Instagram at officially_JadaStone or my website at www.jadastonemusic.com. Quit calling my phone.
New Nation Radio.
Yo, welcome back to the show. Like I said, if you're listening to this, this is a revolution, and you are tuned into Black Empowerment Movement Radio, man. We was talking about Sandra Bland. I was on the phone with Master Lou, man, and he made some good points. I mean, you got to be polite to the police. You can't just be an asshole because, that's how you get snatched to the ground. That's how you get hurt. You understand me? But let me get back to some of that video, and let me stop saying y'all got me nervous off in here, man. Third season, we back. New Nation Radio.
Turn around.
Why don't you tell me that part?
I'm giving you a lawful order. Turn around.
Why will you not tell me?
You are not going on.
I'm not complaining because you just pulled me out of my car.
Turn around.
Are you fucking kidding me? This is some bullshit.
Put your hands behind your back.
Because you know this is straight bullshit. And you full of shit. Full of straight shit. That's how y'all are some scary fucking cops. South Carolina, that's how bitch ass is scared. That's all it is. Fucking scared of a teenager.
If you would have just listened.
I was trying to sign the fucking ticket. Whatever.
Stop moving.
Are you fucking serious?
Stop moving.
Oh, I can't wait till we go to court. Oh, I can't wait. I cannot wait till we go to court. I can't wait. Oh, I can't wait. You want to sit down now?
No. Or you going to jump? You going to throw me to the floor?
That make you feel bad about yourself?
I'll get off.
No, that make you feel bad about yourself? That make you feel real good, woman. Pussy ass. Fucking pussy. For a failure figure, you get all of this. The little ass failure you said, my God, they must have...
You ain't getting a warning. Until now, you're going to jail.
I'm getting a... For what?
You can come
for
read.
What?
Come read right...
I'm getting a warning for what?
Stay right here.
For what? Will you stop turning me over there?
I said stay right
get
here.
Get your fucking mouth right. Let me... Oh, I swear on my life, y'all from prison. A pussy ass cop for a fucking figure. You are
getting
me jail.
He's in handcuffs.
What a pussy. What a pussy.
Hey,
you got to break my fucking wrist.
Stop moving.
I'm standing still. You can't move your knee, goddammit.
Stay right there.
Don't touch me. Fucking pussy for a traffic ticket. Get out of here, shit.
Summary right over here. This right here says a warning. You started creating the problem.
You asked me what was wrong.
You have
I'm trying to tell you.
Person that's
do you feel like I got anything on me? This is a fucking maxi dress.
I'm going to move your glasses.
This is a maxi dress.
Come on over here.
Come on over here. Asshole. Fuck. You're about to break my wrist. Can you stop? You are about to fucking break my wrist.
Stop. Stop now.
fucking trash.
Now stop.
You are such a pussy. You are such a pussy.
No, you are. You're yanking around.
You're a traffic signal.
You are yanking around. When you pull away from me, you're resisting arrest.
Just make you feel real good, don't it? If you want for a traffic signal.
I got it.
I know that makes you feel good, officer.
Okay. Take care of yourself.
I know it makes you feel real good. You're a real man now. You just slammed me, knocked my head in the ground. I got epilepsy, you motherfucker.
Good.
I have
to. Good. I'm about to start resisting.
All right, yeah, this is real good. Real good for a female, yeah. Y'all strong, boo. Y'all real strong.
I want you to wait right here. Wait right here.
I can't go nowhere with your fucking knee in my back, God.
I'm opening your door.
Okay.
You need to leave. You need to leave. You need to leave.
Man, if you can hear, man, she was irate. She was mad and she was pissed off. She didn't understand why she was getting pulled over and why she was getting handled so unlawfully for a traffic violation. And what appears to be a warning, he said he was going to give her a warning or whatever. But long story short, man, you can't talk like that to these police officers. You got to understand, as a black person, most of these white people that are in law enforcement, in the government, they are the descendants and the actual people of white supremacy. You understand me? They just hiding behind the law, the badge. They hiding behind the government. You know what I'm saying? So that's how they camouflage themselves in society and still be efficient enough to assassinate African Americans like they've been doing ever since day one when they brought us here and figured out they don't need us here no more. So they wanted to kill us off and use our women, you know, for body parts and our men for body parts and everything. But we can talk about that some other time, man. But we finna get back to the music. When I come back, we're going to talk about the Michael Brown anniversary, the one-year anniversary, and the riots that's been going on up there, man. I really want to talk about that. And then we're going to talk about later on Christian Taylor, the college football player who was shot by the police officer. Was it excessive force or was it, you know, the officer trying to protect himself? You are listening to BIM New Nation Radio. I'll talk to you in a minute, all right? All right, stay tuned. Very well.
me I would do. But somewhere down the road, you felt the change in the weather and told me that you had a journey on. A kiss in the wind and your love was gone, long gone. Now you say you never meant to play your games, but girl, don't you know it's far too late? Because you let our love just fall apart. You no longer have my heart. I'm doing just fine, getting along.
Somebody order pancakes, I just sip the scissor. That right there could drive a sane man bizzard. Not to worry, Mr. Ace to the Izzles back to Wizard.
How do you console my mom?
Or give her light support? Telling her son's on life support. And just imagine how my girl feel. On the plane, scared as hell that a guy looked like Emmett Till. She was with me before the deal. She been trying to be mine. She a Delta, so she been throwing that dynasty sign. No use me trying to be lying. I've been trying to be signed. Trying to be a millionaire. How I use two lifelines. In the same hospital where Biggie Smalls died. The doctor said I had blood clots. But I ain't Jamaican, man. Story on MTV. And I ain't trying to make a band. I swear this right here. History in the making, man.
I really apologize to everyone right now if it's unclear at all, man. They got my mouth wired shut for like, I don't know, the doctor said like 6 weeks. You know, I had reconstructive surgery on my jaw. I looked in the mirror, half of my jaw was in the back of my mouth, man. I couldn't believe it. And I'm still here for y'all right now, man. This is what I got to say right here, dog.
Yeah, turn me up, yeah.
What if somebody from the shadow was ill? Got a deal on the hottest rap label of Brown. But he wasn't talking about coke and birds, it was more like spoken word. Except he's really putting it down. And he explained the story about how blacks came from glory and what we need to do in a game. Good dude, bad night, right place, wrong time. In the blink of an eye, his whole life changed. If you could feel how my face felt, you would know how Mace felt. Thank God I ain't too cool for the sake of belt. I swear to God, driver 212. I got a lawyer for the case to keep us in my safe. Safe, my jaws couldn't tell if I looked like Tom Cruise on Vanilla Sky. It was televised. It's been an accident like Geico. They thought I was burnt up like Pepsi did Michael. I must got an angel, cause look how death missed his ass. Unbreakable, what you thought they call me, Mr. Glass? Look back on my life like the ghost of Christmas past. Toys R Us where I used to spend that Christmas cash. And I still won't grow up. I'm a grown ass kid. Swear I should be locked up for stupid shit that I did. But I'm a champion, so I turn tragedy to triumph. Make music that's fire, get my soul through the wire.
You know what I'm saying? When the doctor told me I had I was glad to play in my champ. I said, dog, did you realize I'd never make it on a plane now? It's bad enough I got all this jewelry on. She can't be serious, man.
What up, everybody? It's your girl Coco, host of the new show, Sister Girl on New Nation Radio, Mondays at 9 a.m.
New Nation Radio with Dance Radio.
Welcome back to the revolution. Welcome back to Black Empowerment Movement Radio. It's your host, Science. And we've been having a good show so far. I feel real good about everything that's going on. I want to say rest in peace to Sandra Bland, man. And also a tragic happening that just happened. Check this out.
Investigating the deadly shooting of a 19-year-old man inside a car dealership. Officer Brad Miller fired that shot, and now he is on administrative leave. Joel Thomas is live with new details at Classic Buick GMC.
Well, we're actually over at police headquarters, where officers here are telling me that they know they're going to be under a lot of scrutiny. They say this was a rookie officer who shot the unarmed 19-year-old who had broken into that car dealership.
There could have been, you know, too much drinking, or could have been the wrong place at the wrong time, could have got something that you don't know what you're getting, could have been, you know, probably with your grip, I don't know.
Adrian Taylor can't imagine what prompted his 19-year-old son, Christian James Taylor, to smash his SUV into this car dealership early Friday morning. The police confronted him when he did. That's when 49-year-old Brad Miller, an officer still in training, shot and killed Taylor. Police say Taylor was not carrying a weapon.
The department is sad for the loss of this life, and we are committed to providing our community we serve a clear and transparent investigation. We will hold ourselves accountable to the highest standards of policing.
His dad says Taylor was in his first year of college at San Angelo.
No real problems. Good dude, man.
Taylor says no matter what his son was doing at the car dealership, he should not have been killed.
What he's done ain't no way right.
That ain't right, man. That ain't right. It's like, you can walk around here with no gun and still get killed like you have a gun. So why don't we have guns? And one thing you got to know about America, man, you can't pick up a gun and you can't do something if you're not ready to suffer the consequence. And if you don't know what the consequence is, the consequence is death. And that's what they bring to us. Every time any black person step out of line, and I guess in their mind, or get out of line, they automatically kill us. This man was 19 years old, college student. You understand me? I don't know why he crashed his truck into the dealership. You know, maybe it was some kind of initiation for fraternity. Maybe like his dad said, he had a problem with his girlfriend. But no matter what's going on, man, the police should be able to calm a situation no matter what's going on, especially if it's an unarmed person. And they keep saying just because he a rookie, but this man is 49 years old. So rookie or not, you're a 49-year-old dude, and you in law enforcement, you should have the right mindset to know that this is a young dude, he's no gun, and you know, he's not a threat. Obviously, he must have started fighting him or something, and then that's what happened. I guess it was a physical altercation. But see, you just can't do these things in America, man. You can't survive a traffic stop, and you can't survive altercation with the police without dying, being black in America. And if you want to start a revolution, that is not the way to do it. It's not the way to do it. We got to do it better, and we're going to talk about that the next show, all right? So y'all make sure y'all tune in to our show next time. Oh, yeah, matter of fact, also, the riots in Ferguson. And it's crazy, it seems like the killing of Christian Taylor and the riots or the 1-year anniversary to Michael Brown is around the same time. So you think about it, is it a government conspiracy? Are they trying to make us mad and piss us off to the point where we attack them so they can kill us and get rid of us? Is it, you know, reverse psychology? What is it? What do you think it is? Y'all think about that. Tune in next week. And we're going to talk about more of this, and we'll talk about even more. Like I said, it's season 3. We're back on the air. So I got a live interview with a prominent black man in society, a college professor in his 60s, I think. Shout out to Mr. Foster. He's coming to the show so he can give us some insight and some history lessons, all right? So y'all make sure y'all stay tuned. And thank you for tuning in. This your boy, Science, signing out. Bim. Yeah. All day. New Nation Radio, man.
Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and make you want me.
Now that I escape, sleep, walk awake. Yeah. Those who correlate know the world they kick. Jail bars ain't golden gates. Those who fake, they break. When they meet their 400-pound mate, if I could rule the world, everyone would have a gun in the ghetto, of course. We get D up and on their horse. Kick around, drinking moonshine. I pour a sip on the concrete for the deceased, but no, don't weep. Why Clef's in a state of sleep, thinking about the robbery that I did last week. Money in the bag, banker look like a drag. I want to play with pelicans from here to Baghdad. Gun blast, think fast, I think I'm
here. Bam.
I'm gonna pinch my hips to see if I still exist. I think not, I'll send a letter to my friends. A born again hooligan, only to be king again.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. I play my enemies like a game of chess where I rest. No stress if you don't smoke cess. Less, I must confess, my destiny's manifest. There's some cortex and sweats. I make tracks like I'm homeless. Rap orgies with Borgie and Bess. Capture your bounty like Elliot Ness. Yes, bless you if you represent the fool. But I hex you with some witches brew if you do do. Voodoo, I could do what you do. Easy, believe me, frontin' niggas give me heebie-jeebies. So why you imitating Al Capone? I be Nina Simone and defecating on your microphone. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you. Lonely. You can't run away from these stars I got, oh baby, hey baby, cause I got a lot, oh yeah. Anywhere you go, my whole crew gonna know, oh baby, hey baby, you can't hide from the bag, oh no.
Ready or not, refugees
taking over. The Buffalo Soldier, dreadlock roster. On the 12th hour, fly by in my bomber. Crews run for cover, now they under pushing up flowers. Super fly, true lies do or die. Toss me high, only puff fly with my crew from like high. I, refugee from Guantanamo Bay. That's around the border like I'm Cassius Clay.
Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide.
Ain't nobody.
Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide.
Ain't nobody.
Gonna find you and make you want me. Ready or not, here I come.
Hey, before I let y'all go, man, y'all gotta understand, don't forget, this is a revolution, alright? Be careful out there, watch your family, you know, mind your manners, you know, be an upstanding citizen, and play by the rules, because we are targets of the government, of the central banking systems, and the global white supremacy. So, until next time, keep cool, real talk, because that kid, it's your boy Science. Bam! Oh, we got a caller. I'm out of this thing. Till next time.
Leaving all the competition in the dust.